Every generation is dumb, in case you haven't seen it. The oldies have Joe and Nancy, and the youngins have AOC. And we're about to have an epic showdown, possibly with monkeypox. The only thing that unites all of these people is the hatred of Orange Man Bad. Let me explain. Back in my day, we looked up to our elders and we respected adults. Then I grew up, and those adults got older, but not at all wiser.
Should Americans be prepared for a recession? In your view, is a recession in the United States inevitable?
No.
What was that, old man? Did I hear a no?
Look, you're talking about the significant progress we've made in making sure we don't have supply chain backups, about the 8,000 jobs that Hyundai is going to be bringing to Georgia, 3,000 jobs to Texas from Samsung, $17 billion investment, Toyota, 1,700 jobs in North Carolina on battery technology, the situation where we're at, we've created over 8 million new jobs, where unemployment's down to 3.6%, and so on and so forth, as if they're a problem. Imagine where we'd be with Putin's tax and the war in Ukraine had we not made that enormous progress.
Look, go get that electric vehicle as you imagine where we'd be if Joe was never put in office, and then cry yourself to sleep tonight. Just as a reminder, Joe is part of the silent generation, and he should really take that title seriously. Please, Joe, just shush yourself. But even if Joe stays silent, his boomer wife, the greatest Dr. J who doesn't play basketball, Jill Biden, will carry the country into oblivion. She'll inspire the next generation, or at least those in Ecuador, to come to America because she has no understanding of pretty much anything.
What does inequality in the United States matter to young people right here in Quito? But they do matter. Injustice and corruption, poverty and pollution, disease and despair, they aren't contained by any borders. If we learned anything from the COVID-19 pandemic, from these last few years of sickness and sorrow, it's how one deadly virus can move through the world.
The audio was as off as her message. Which brings us to the question this week. Which of the silent generation or the boomers or those younger ones has proven they should be shushed the most? Let me know your thoughts in the comments and please share the desire for the shushing of these people. From the greatest doctor in the White House to the other greatest doctor in the White House, the Fauci must have just seen the bat signal. Or hopefully not, because it probably means another Wuhan disease is a-coming. But anyway, the monkeypox is upon us, and you should be terrified.
What if your health advisors told you your level of concern should be about monkeypox and the cases that are in the United States and around the world?
Well, they haven't told me the level of exposure yet, but it is something that everybody should be concerned about. We're working on it hard to figure out what we do and what vaccine, if any, may be available for. But it is a concern in the sense that if it were to spread, it's consequential.
I mean, we don't know what's happening, but we're working really hard on it. Top priority, I'm sure. Please, someone, give that man a sticker for his efforts. But what could Dr. Anthony Fauci do for us in this instance? Glad you asked. The Fauci was the demon in charge of that AIDS research back in the 80s, and now he's in his 80s, so he should front this non-pandemic that is being made to be a big deal. And it's because this monkeypox is spreading through, you know, men having sex with one another. Now, it may not be the only way it spreads, but when one man's monkey is inserted into another man, the pox has been appearing. Hey, I'm just saying that if San Francisco has an outbreak, the leading theory will be the answer. And on the note of San Francisco, how about Nancy, the good Catholic Pelosi? She's just out there doing all good things, like claiming abortion is a kitchen table issue.
Thank you for giving me the opportunity to talk about the optimism we have about how urgent this election is. Our democracy is on the ballot. People expect that to be taken care of. They want to know what we're doing about their kitchen table issues, food, education, prescription drugs. You want to talk about prescription drugs? We're only 12 of them bought it with us to make insulin cheaper. So our democracy on the ballot, freedom that springs from our democracy on the ballot. A woman's right to choose is on the ballot, and that is a kitchen table issue.
Stay away from my kitchen table, Nancy. But hey, almost as if it's divine providence, on the very same day, San Francisco Archbishop Salvatore Corleone banned Nancy from receiving Holy Communion. He said about Pelosi that more recently, her advocacy for codifying the Roe decision into federal law, it's becoming more and more extreme and more aggressive. And he's been trying to speak with her about it. He also said he believes Pelosi that she's a devout Catholic, but added, which makes me perplexed at why she would be so forceful on this issue as a politician. He said it's very tricky as a politician. There are so many issues to balance out in trying to come to some kind of consensus and compromise and all that. But to be so aggressively promoting it, that's not what a devout Catholic does. Obviously, Nancy had her favorite abortion defenders. The San Francisco Examiner chimed in with an editorial saying the attack on Nancy Pelosi should be San Francisco Archbishop's final act here. Nancy actually did get communion a few days later, like a rebel or a heathen, whichever you want to say, because she was in Washington, D.C., where she pretends to represent her constituents. Nancy finally responded to the Archbishop's ban by pivoting and making her usual absurd claims because she's a good Catholic, after all.
I wonder about death penalty, which I am opposed to. Mm. So is the church, but they take no action against people who may not share their view. Thank you for referencing the Gospel of Matthew, which is sort of the agenda of the church that is rejected by many who side with them on terminating a pregnancy. So we just have to be prayerful. We have to be respectful. I come from a largely pro-life Italian-American Catholic family. So I respect people's views about that, but I don't respect us foisting it onto others.
And then you have Whoopi Goldberg giving her view.
The abortion rights battle is starting to blur the lines between church and state. The Archbishop of San Francisco is calling for Speaker Nancy Pelosi to be denied receiving communion because of her pro-choice stance. He's one of the priests who also called for President Biden to be denied sacrament. This is not your job, dude. That is not up to you to make that decision.
Well, dude, Whoopi clearly did not take her own advice.
That's what you need. You have to put attitude in what you're saying. You have to think about what you're singing. It's not just quacking. This is rejoicing. You are singing to the Lord.
But instead, you know what Whoopi just did right there? It figures that a Karen like Karen Elaine Johnson, or Whoopi, as you may know her, would come to Nancy's defense because she knows all about Catholicism.
You know, what is the saying? It's kind of amazing. But, you know, what is the point of communion? Right? It's for sinners. It's for sinners. It's the reward of saints, but the bread of sinners. How dare you? How dare you?
There's only one thing left to say to Whoopi.
Bless you.
As we know, both Nancy and Whoopi have a special fondness for their President Joe Biden.
I love it, I love it, I love it.
And they will do anything for him.
I will follow him wherever he may go.
There isn't an abortion too evil, a hatefulness so high you can keep them away from his lies. And if you think that's extreme, just listen to the good Catholic.
I'm not, I have absolutely no intention of the Democrats not winning the House in November. I think that in terms of our the work that this president has done, and he's been a great president. I don't know about polls, but I do know about winning the races one district at a time.
On the note of love, big breaking news that absolutely no one cares about. The one and thankfully only Representative Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez just got engaged. So she's probably singing this as well. I just love that song. So you got to hear it again. Sorry, not sorry. Now, I'm not sure if AOC started the wedding planning, but I hope she doesn't choose to have any of the reception at the Lincoln Memorial, because those of her generation have already ruined it enough. Over the weekend, the Lincoln Memorial had to close after there was a graduation celebration whose participants left the place trashed with litter, broken bottles, and spilled wine and champagne all over the steps. I think you all join me in the same response.
I have no respect. I don't get no respect at all. Are you kidding?
These hooligans have been at the university for probably 6 years, which is the average time now for anyone to finish all their gender studies and social justice coursework. But if they would have just joined the choir, they may have been taught to be joyful, joyful.
Joyful, joyful, Lord, we adore thee.
Joining that choir would have taught those students how to be down with G-O-D. Yeah, you know me. It's quite apparent that most students in America need an actual education. Because after seeing the latest Man on the Street interview for Fleckus Talks, I am convinced they have received zero information that is helpful, and I'm confident that we're all doomed.
It's probably like, I don't know, like 1901?
Yes, very good.
It is?
It was close, around there, but I'll give it to you. Who fought in the Civil War?
I don't know.
Do you know how many continents there are?
No.
How many states make up the United States?
How many states make... Dude!
Dude! How dare you assume that person's gender? As you can see from the last umpteen minutes, all of our generations have dum-dums. And they have people who just need to shush, because they are making the world a worse place. All of them need a little bit more of being joyful, joyful, and being down with G-O-D. And they need to keep close their Fs. Faith, family, and friends. Now, if you'd share this video, you'll be joining in making the world a better place. Until next time, stay healthy, America.